I had the privilege of representing this city for 11 years as a professional footballer, and also for 4 as the assistant manager of the football club. Because of that, many people in this district know me because my professional life was lived out in the public. And through that, they also know of my Christian faith. It was back in 2002, whilst praying one night, that the seed of 1 in a million was placed in my heart. And I carried that for 3 years. In 2005, I was introduced to Matthew Band, a local businessman who shared the same heart and passion for these children and young people. We met every Wednesday to strategically map out what 1 in a million would look like and how we could achieve our goal through our hub and spoke model. Together, it was our passion to bring hope and to lift aspirations for the children and young people in Bradford, enhancing their life chances. Our purpose as a charity was and is to primarily work with disadvantaged children and young people through sports, arts, and enterprise, using formal and informal education to break those cycles of deprivation over their young lives, valuing them and celebrating their uniqueness and letting them know they are 1 in a million. We believe all children are unique and we value them for that. The children are at the heart of all we do, and so are our values: compassion, honesty, integrity, and excellence. These are our DNA. These are what run right through 1 in a million. The charity's objectives are implemented through 6 main activity areas: community, positive lifestyle, alternative education, corporate events and sponsorship, youth offending team, and of course, our free school. In our community department, we have seen significant growth. We now have 5 community activators working within the 5 constituencies of Bradford, with community bases in Canterbury, Byerley, Manningham, Shipley, and Keighley. Our streetwise football project, supported and attended by West Yorkshire Police, and our indoor sports hall athletics remain flagship activities. However, we are delighted that our qualified coaches now deliver more than 25 different types of engagement activities and taster courses, all which we hope will lead through to our development programmes. We have more planned for the year ahead. During a recent survey of over 250 young people, 100% said, "My coach is qualified and very knowledgeable." And 98% said they feel safe while at one of our evening projects when it's dark. Positive lifestyle is new under the governance of 1 in a million. It's unique in Bradford and is purposely an out-of-school experience for primary school children. Through our partnership with Bradford City, students get to have a tour of the stadium, visit pitch side, and also the changing rooms before entering a classroom. This year, the centre enjoyed seeing its 25,000th student attend one of our workshops. We've seen attendance for the year increase by 23%, with over 2,850 students attending, the highest in its history. Our alternative education provision works as a service provider in partnership with the Bradford District PRU, as well as working directly with schools. We educate hard to reach young people who have been excluded from mainstream education. For many learners, crossing the threshold is a huge challenge. Our hope is that, as well as providing skills and qualifications, we build resilience, confidence, and self-esteem in these young people. Corporate events and sponsorship is the charity's fundraising department. Their work is split into 2 areas: restricted and unrestricted funding. During 2014 and 15, 257 individuals from 46 Bradford-based companies participated in our fundraising events, ranging from corporate golf days, runs, walks, pro-am football, and even jumping out of aeroplanes. A number of organisations have also nominated us as their Charity of the Year. We'd like to thank each and every one of you who has volunteered, fundraised, or donated to One in a Million. Thank you. 2 years ago, we entered into a partnership with the Bradford Youth Offending Team, who are part of the Bradford Metropolitan District Council. They work with young people involved within the criminal justice system. They work to prevent young people who are under 18 from offending or re-offending. Our free school is a secondary school centrally funded by the government. When full in 2019, our school will have 420 students. Our hope and passion is that our young people thrive when they see the relevance of their education. With that in mind, we are committed to developing three key areas: sports, arts, and enterprise. Based on the US charter model, our school has small classroom sizes and a pedagogy that is framed around the four modes of learning: instructional, conceptual, collaborative, and personal. Apple technology is at the heart of all students' learning, and each student has either an iPad or a Google Chromebook. During our recent Ofsted Parent View survey, 98% of parents said they would recommend this school to other parents. Our students are encouraged that resilience plus hard work equals growth, leading to an I can attitude. Each week, across our organisation, we get to hear many incredible stories of children and young people's lives getting impacted, transformed, redirected into new pathways, and for some, their life chances being increased. Let me give you a snapshot of just a few recent testimonials. Let me tell you about Amber, who first attended our indoor athletics program several years ago. As a result of her rapid development, Amber has since gone on to compete four times at the UK finals in sports hall athletics, four times at the English Schools Championship, and represented the North East region in the 100 metres at the UK School Games. She has won the Yorkshire Championship and the Inter-Counties Championships in the 100 metres this past season. And what about Krishan, who attends our weekly Streetwise football and football school summer camps? Recently, one of our coaches recognised his talent and recommended him to the Bradford City Futsal programme. Krishan was then called up to represent the England futsal team. What an incredible achievement and experience for him. Then there is the wonderful Tina Dalby, who first connected with One in a Million back in 2007, attending our Saturday morning kids club, as well as helping her dad to give out refreshments at our Streetwise football in Canterbury. With a passion for dance, at the age of 14, she began to lead our dance group performing around the city. It's our great joy that during the last year, Tina has found employment in a nursery. Or how about one of our new Year 7 students from our school who recently said to our principal, "I listened to your assemblies so carefully and today I've been proactive. I sat next to a boy who couldn't cut up his food properly and so I leaned over and helped him." We at One in a Million will never tire of these humbling testimonials. We hope that with your support, there'll be many, many more to come. As an organisation, One in a Million now works with, on average, over 1,000 children and young people attending weekly activities across our city. That's 20% growth on last year. while still remaining as committed as ever to deepening the personal experience for each and every one of them, valuing them and letting them know they are one in a million. This work has been achievable thanks to the Provident Good Neighbours Programme, the Cloth Workers Foundation, Children in Need, and the Shears Foundation, and many more trust funds who have donated to us. And not forgetting, of course, all of our valued individual partners and fundraisers. Thank you. I'd also like to thank all of our ambassadors from the world of sport, arts, and enterprise, and our community partners, Bradford City Football Club, the Bulls Foundation, and Yorkshire Cricket Foundation. Thank you. We believe it takes a community to raise a child. We all can play our part. Thank you to you, the One in a Million community, from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you for believing in the work we do and supporting us. Together, we are making a difference to the lives of children and young people in Bradford. It's our city, it's our time. Let's make it count.